dead LG mobile after overheating. In April 2021, LG Electronics announced it would shut down its mobile phone business worldwide. The decision was made following years of financial losses for its mobile phone division. As a result, LG is not expected to launch new phone models in the future. However, the company pledged to provide support and software updates for existing models for a set period. Even the existing inventory of LG phone models may continue to be available in some places until sold out. Today we are going to see if this breakdown has anything to do with the previous news. Guys, here's Leonardo, and today we are going to fully understand the planned obsolescence of LG devices. We take a tester or multimeter, we connect the charger cable to the device, and we are going to measure the voltages of the battery connector. We have no voltage at the battery connector. However, we have voltage at the test point. We have a voltage of 4.66 volts, which indicates that current is reaching the motherboard from the charger. We remove the motherboard and we can see that we have 1.75 volts on the power button. We continue gathering information and in the end we need to draw a solid conclusion and a good diagnosis. In the next step, we remove the motherboard for a visual inspection. Due to overheating, we can observe solder boards on the SMD components. Indeed, we can see many balls all over the motherboard. This means that the device has overheated a lot. We continue inspecting other sectors as well, and the same, we have dozens and dozens of balls around the components. At this point, I personally prefer not to work on this device, but as I have some free time, I'm going to get my hands on it so we can understand where the failure of this device is. We are going to remove the shields. To remove the shields, I use two methods, the first with the mini Dremel and the second one with an air station. Soon I will edit a video talking about the best mini Dremel and which method is best for removing shields. In today's tutorial, we are not going to waste time with this process. We continue with the visual inspection under a microscope, more of the same, we have solder balls everywhere. I think that with some update they have ruined the motherboard and this way they wash their hands of customers. We are going to measure next to this IC, which is the PM7250B, and we can see a short circuit in these capacitors. By connecting the charger to the mobile, we have a consumption of 0.4 amperes or 400 milliamperes, which is quite a large consumption. We go to the thermal camera to see what's happening. We can see here in the memory we have an area that heats up too much and it's not normal. In the next step, we are going to lift the memory. In this way, we'll know where the failure is. To remove the memory, I use a hot air station at 400 Celsius degrees and 40% airflow and no nozzle. I always try to distribute the temperature evenly and use a flexible metal tool. I forgot to record, but the short circuit on the motherboard is gone, so I'm going to rebuild the memory and see what happens. To clean the integrated circuit, I use a little flux, the desoldering wick and the soldering iron at 350 Celsius degrees. Here's a tip, don't press too hard with the soldering iron when you remove the old solder lid. We just have to go over it without putting too much pressure. In the description of this video, I will leave you the purchase link with all the tools we use in our workshop. Now we use a piece of cotton and contact cleaner to leave the circuit clean. I don't like this area at all. We can see these gray pads that have clearly suffered from overheating. We move to the motherboard and we perform the same process. A little flux, low temperature solder paste and we change the solder alloy. This way, using a low temperature solder paste makes it easier to clean the old solder lid. The motherboard should be left like this, very flat. This way we will have no problem soldering any integrated circuit. It doesn't matter if you work with the CPU, the memory, any PMIC or charging IC. The process is the same for any integrated circuit. To rebuild the memory, we use an economical stencil and 183 Celsius degrees solder paste. As a general rule, for any reballing, we use 183 Celsius degrees solder paste. The temperature on the hot air station is 300 Celsius degrees and 40% airflow. The truth is that we can use any temperature above 250 Celsius degrees. to leave a well done job, after removing the stencil, we are going to apply a little heat so that the balls are centered uniformly. Before soldering the memory, we have to apply a little flux. In this way, we are going to improve the soldering of the circuit. To solder the circuit, we apply 380 Celsius degrees and 40% airflow without a nozzle. You can see how the integrated circuit settles itself when the melting temperature reaches the optimal temperature. The last step is to clean the area using contact cleaner and isopropyl alcohol. We are going to check the motherboard using the thermal camera. We can see that the short circuit has returned and the memory heats up in the same sector, which indicates that internally the memory is damaged. Some diode or any component has shorted. Guys, here's Leonardo. We want to thank you for watching us and we were expecting for you in the next tutorial. Bye bye!